citizen.
I mostly deal with petty thievery and drunken brawls. Been too long since we've had a good bandit raid.
My husband Matthias and I tend Corpse Light Farm.
A sad time. The cemetery is ancient. It's been here longer than the town. I'm no scholar, but I know that a lot of battles have been fought here over the course of history. After each battle, more dead were buried and the graveyard got bigger. I heard it's now the biggest graveyard in Skyrim. Yes, and I couldn't tell you why. My wife and I think there's some dark magic at work. Perhaps RK's influence is strong here, and he likes to keep it this way. Our daughter, our little girl. She hadn't seen her tenth winter. She was. He ripped her apart, like a saber cat tears a deer. We barely found enough of her to bury. Sinding came true as a laborer. Seemed like a decent man. He's stewing in the pit while we figure out what to do with him. If you've got the stomach to look at him, what could drive a man to do something like this?
Honest pay for honest work. I just don't understand what kind of man does that.
I'm sorry, I should really go now. Help you. I'm just Dengir's maid.
Come on in. Just stoke the fire. Take a seat and get the cold out.
I'm a bard, trained at the Bard's College in Solitude. Wanderers like you should think about applying. Keep a song in your heart to ward off the gloom.
At some point, we should hire Tekla on here. If she could just spend less time serving Deng.
I wish I could afford to pay you both, Nari. I really do.
Horse bones. Handsome man in Falkreath. Depends. Are you thirsty? Hungry? Both? Aye.
Welcome to Dead Man's Drink. I escaped fighting in Cyrodiil, only to have it track me. People say there's someone in Riften that can change your face. Make you look completely different. Do you believe that? The people of Skyrim don't like magic much, so but take a look. You hear any juicy gossip in town? Be sure to share it with me.
What do you think you're
that
doing?
That isn't yours.
Come quiet. By the order of the Jarl. Stop right there.
Smart man. Now come along with us. We'll take any stolen goods and you'll be free to go. After you pay the fine, of course.
What is it?
Don't let the shop's name frighten you away. I have plenty of reliable tonics and healing potions to sell. Well, my family back in Hammerfell didn't approve of my interest in lethal poisons and death in general, so I left and wandered north. When I found this town, with its huge cemetery, I felt right at home. I opened the shop, and I've never looked back. This is where I belong. I know it's a bit strange. Not exactly a name to bring comfort to the sick and ailing who come to buy a poultice or salve. But what you must understand about Falkreath is that our town is defined, for better or worse, by the large and ancient cemetery here. That's why the inn is called Dead Man's Drink, the farm is called Corpse Light Farm, and so on. I suppose it's sort of a running joke. Take a look. Take a look. Until next time. Call upon me if I can be of any service.
Trouble?
Sidgir can sometimes act too quickly, but he does listen to Helvert and I. It was Dengir who made me a steward, long ago when he was young. When Dengir's health began to fail, young Sidgir was appointed Jarl in his stead. It was simpler just to keep me as steward. Sidgir has no interest in running his hold, and so leaves such matters to me. As for my part, I do my best to see that folk are treated fairly. Many battles have been fought here over the centuries. Graves were dug and monuments built, and a town grew around these. In time, Falkreath came to be known as the Hero's Graveyard. Many noble jarls and renowned warriors asked to be buried here. Falkreath's reputation has faded somewhat, but the graves remain, reminding us of the one inevitable truth of life. May wisdom forever light your path.
I protect the Jarl, whoever that might be.
Yes, what is it that... Boland speaks much about the war and the Stormcloaks, but he knows who provides. My uncle Dengir was Jarl until a short time ago. His old age and failing health caught up with him, and he stepped down. He now serves us honorably as Thane, and to the great benefit of the Hold, I now serve as Jarl. Difficult? I'm a Jarl. I eat the most succulent meat, drink the finest ale, and hunt with the best hounds in the Hold. Meanwhile, my very capable steward sees to the needs of the small folk and ensures that my hold runs smoothly. Being a Jarl could hardly be simpler. You should try it sometime. Work? I demand tribute before you can be considered for any real tasks. How about drink? None of that local piss. Real Blackbriar mead, fresh from Riften. Then I don't have time for you. Come and see me again sometime. I might have some... The Stormcloaks want free work. I demand tribute before you can be considered for any real tasks. Yes, work. I demand tribute before you can be considered for any real tasks. How about drink? None of that... You better. I hate people who waste my time. Come and see me again sometime. I might have some use for you.
I'm the steward here. I serve under Jarl Sidgir and Jarl Dengir before him. Sidgir can sometimes act too quickly, but he does listen to Helvard and I.
Steel's good, but loyalty's better. I'm loyal to Dengir first, and the Empire second. Blades? Helmets. Pretty much anything to suit your needs.
Only inside the gates. Much of Falkreath Hold is wilderness, and there's plenty of trouble to be had. Only inside the gates. Much of Falkreath Hold. Only inside the gates. Much of Falkreath Hold is... I was Dengir's personal guard for years. I risked my hide more than once to protect him. Why would I do that? For money? Because I swore an oath? No. It was because he was a good man and a true friend. A true Nord places loyalty and honor above all else.
See me at my forge if you need arms or armor.
I'm sorry, I should really go now.
Shorst bones. Handsome man in Falkreath.
I can't really help you. I'm just Dengir's maid.
Unless you intend to bury someone, this isn't the place you're looking for, traveler. Falkreath is known for its graveyard, traveler. We've buried more dead than you can imagine. I just finished giving my old war companion Barrett a proper burial by fire. Old Hardhead hated the idea of being lost cold in the ground. Could you deliver the ashes to Runil, the priest of Arkay? He'll know the right blessings to make for Barrett's soul. Typical.
Let me know if you see anything you like.
Well met. Unlike my brother, I've no dislike of strangers. Met lots of them while I was a Stormcloak. Take a look. Steal anything from my shop, and you'll regret it.
I'd be a lot warmer and a lot happier with a belly full of meat. Helgen. Destroyed by a dragon. Hard to believe, isn't it?
No lollygagging.
Disrespect the law and you disrespect me.
You wear the armor of a brigand. Best not cause any trouble on my watch. Stay out of trouble, Argonian.
Good afternoon. Come to gawk at the monster? Believe me, it wasn't anything I ever intended to do. I just lost control. I tried to tell them, but none of them believed me. It's all on account of this blasted ring. This is the ring of Hircine. I was told it could let me control my transformations. Perhaps it used to, but I'll never know. Hircine didn't care for my taking it and threw a curse on it. I put it on, and the changes just came to me. I could never guess when. It would be at the worst times, like with the little girl. I don't suppose there's a point in keeping the secret if I'm going to die in here anyway. I'm sure you've heard of men who shift to beasts under the influence of the moons. I am one of them. A werewolf. It's my secret. And my shame. That's why I wanted the ring. It was said to give men like me control. Now, I may look like a man, but I still feel the animal inside of me as strong as ever. Do you not know the Daedric Lord of the Hunt? He revels in the chase, and also gave the gift of lycanthropy to mortals. A powerful force not to be crossed, as I learned too late. I've been looking for a way to appease Hircine. There is a certain beast in these lands. Large, majestic. It's said that Hircine will commune with whoever slays it. I tracked it into these woods, but then I had my accident with the child. I want to beg his forgiveness. Give him back the ring. But while I'm stuck in here, the beast wanders free. I had just come into Falkreath. They needed some help working the mill, and I thought that would be something safe, something I could do. When I saw the little girl, I could feel it coming on. I could taste her. I needed to hunt, but this pitiful, limited body wasn't meant for hunting. Slow, no claws, weak, mashing teeth for chewing cud. I held in my rage as long as I could, but it boiled inside of me. She looked so fragile, helpless prey, and then I feel terrible about what happened, about what I did. It would probably be best for everyone if I just went away. Oh my, you would do this for me? Here, take it. I don't want anything to do with this wretched thing anymore. Seek out the beast. He wanders these woods. Bring him down and the Lord of the Hunt should smile on you. I wish you luck, but you leave here while I still have my skin. Should our paths cross again, I will remember your kindness. Farewell. Good afternoon.
Well met, Hunter. I am the spirit of the hunt. Just one glimpse of the glorious stalker that your kind calls Hircine. Your fealty is precious to me. I will make good use of it. You bear my ring. The one who stole it has fled to what he thinks is his sanctuary. Just as a bear climbs a tree to escape the hunt, but only ends up trapping himself. Seek out this rogue shifter. Tear the skin from his body and make it an offering to me. Fly, my hunter. There are others who vie for my favor. A bit of competition. Don't dally while the prey flees.
Teach you to mess with me. This doesn't concern you, citizen. This doesn't concern you, citizen.
doesn't concern you, citizen. You're interfering with official Thormor business.